Fat Tuesday. It is right around the corner, and we've got an easy way to cook up something festive with a Cajun kick. And this rice dish isn't just a side, it can be the star of your meal.
That's right. Sheila Johnson, the founder of Gangsta Goody's Kitchen, is here to show us how to make her version of dirty rice. But let's start at the beginning. Let's put on the brakes real fast. Do you have, hold on, do we have Mardi Gras beads?
You have Mardi Gras beads for you.
What do I got to do to get these?
Well, since we're on camera, okay, nothing for now.
Watch the Instagram for what happens between the commercials.
Yes.
Okay, now that we're outfitted appropriately.
Yes, you got your beads.
Got my beads.
Yes.
Let's go back to just what is dirty rice, because I'll be honest, I'm just a country boy from Kansas. Before I met my wife that grew up on the Gulf Coast, I didn't know anything about dirty rice other than that there was a Zatarain's box you could buy at the grocery store for it, you know?
No Zatarain's today.
Okay.
So dirty rice is a part of our history, you know? And so there was a time in our history when the leftovers, you know, from the chicken or... Because typically you have chicken lizards, chicken gizzards. Yes, and chicken liver is what people use to make dirty rice.
Dirty rice? Oh, okay.
And so cooking it in that in some sort of broth is, it would turn it like a brownish, tannish color. And so hence the name dirty rice.
Would get the rice dirty. So so this does originate down
in
like
New Orleans? Yes,
okay.
It does.
All right,
absolutely.
Perfect.
And so it's just in time for Mardi Gras.
Yeah. So let's go ahead and get started here and kind of show us, walk us through what all you have here on the table.
So we have, you can't start a Cajun dish without the Trinity.
Okay.
The Trinity is onions.
Onions.
Okay. We're going to go ahead and put those onions in here.
All right.
And then we have green bell peppers.
Onions, bell peppers.
Mm-hmm. And then celery. Okay.
Celery.
Celery.
Okay.
That makes up the Trinity. Okay. And so.
So every Cajun dish should start with that thing.
It's going to start with the Trinity. Absolutely. Whether it's gumbo, jambalaya, etouffee, you're going to start with the Trinity.
Okay. Perfect.
Okay. And then after that, I'm going to also put in some fresh garlic because I like garlic.
Oh, yeah.
Okay. And you might already be able to start smelling the aromas. And then...
And you're just sauteing that in some olive oil, or you got
butter? I put a little bit of olive oil in there to get that started.
All right.
Because the sausage, now we're using sausage today.
Okay.
So I use a mixture of Italian sausage and Cajun sausage.
Oh, yes. A little bit of spice in
it. It has a little bit of spice in it. And so this is a Cajun seasoning that I made up myself.
Okay.
And so we're going to put a little bit of that in there. We're going to start building that flavor profile.
Yes.
Okay? Mmm.
And just keep mixing that in.
You just keep mixing that in, and then we'll add the sausage, the rice, and this is uncooked rice.
So do you do, when your sausage, because I see you have the is it andouille or is
correct.
It?
Correct. That is correct.
Gotcha.
And so we have some of that that we're going to put in there too. And we're going to go ahead and add our sausage in and let that start cooking.
And you add that in uncooked, so you're going to want to cook that with everything in there
cook
too, right?
Cook that with everything in there, yes. So those flavors will start building for us.
And then I know a lot of the time we'll buy andouille, it's already cooked. So do you want to wait to put that in towards the end then?
Or yes, because this one is already cooked. This is a smoked andouille sausage. And so right before I put the liquid and the rice in, I'll just throw that in.
Perfect. Oh, we only got about 30 seconds left. So real quick, what is this just a broth or what
this
are we using
here? This is a broth.
Here? Okay.
And so this is a beef broth, okay? I wanted it to be a little heartier than chicken broth.
Yeah.
And more so than using water, the broth is going to add a little extra flavor for you.
So that all simmers together with just the rice we have here, and then boom. It all comes out
Absolutely.
Our dirty rice.
Yes.
Real quick, tell us just a couple things you guys got coming up with Gangsta Goody's Kitchen that we need to know about here in the future.
Well, what you need to know is that we're starting to build gangsta style. So gangsta style is everything for the home.
Oh, cool.
So cutting boards, knives, placemats, table runners, pillows, all of those sorts of things.
All right, well, as you are keep talking about that, I'm going to try a little bit of this here real quick.
And let me tell you, when in the Gangsta Goody's Kitchen, when something is good, we say it's fire.
All right, hold on.
Okay.
Oh, yeah, Sheila. That's fire.
It's fire,
That's
okay.
Fire. All right, Belinda, I'll save some of this fire for you.
Absolutely.